shouldn't sound like a welcome of someone that people who are just eaten. So let's welcome. First of all, the first award will go to Air Canada. And at this time, I'd like to invite Steve Goodfellow, the Director of Sales Eastern Canada, to accept the award. Now, here's what the inscription says. It says, CTO Special Recognition Award presented to Air Canada in appreciation of your demonstrated commitment to the development of Caribbean tourism by providing over six decades of outstanding, uninterrupted service to the region. Ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. To Johnson's point, my name is Steve Goodfellow. On behalf of our president and CEO, Calin, and over our 28,000 employees at Air Canada across the world, we're very honored to accept this special recognition award by the Caribbean Tourism Organization. Through the 65 years of uninterrupted service, Air Canada is extremely proud and dedicated to the development and growth of tourism in the Caribbean. Today we fly to over 30 different destinations from Toronto, Montreal, Ottawa, Halifax, and Winnipeg. Air Canada will continue to look at our network and participating partners to ensure our growth within the Caribbean is sustainable and continues to drive growth to Caribbean tourism for years to come. Once again, on behalf of Calin and all of our employees, I thank you very much for this distinguished award. Thank you.
And so pleased are we to present this award. The Secretary General actually presented it twice, as you notice. Thank you very much once again. The next award goes to the Caribbean Airlines, literally Caribbean Airlines, for outstanding service. I'd like to now invite Mr. Tyron Tang, who is the Acting Chief Executive Officer of Caribbean Airlines. In recognition of your continued dedication to the growth and development of Caribbean tourism by providing almost a decade of intra-regional and international service to the Caribbean.
Oops. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. As I stated, I'm Tyron Tang, the acting CEO of Caribbean Airlines. I'm very delighted to be here to accept this award on behalf of Caribbean, and I can assure everyone that Caribbean continues to be committed to the development of the Caribbean region as the premier air transport carrier. We look forward to helping the Tourism Association to grow in their development, and as stated, we look forward to the future developing the entire Caribbean. Thank you very much, and thank you to the Caribbean Tourism Association.
Thank you very much, and thanks, SG. We're going to call you back at some point, but you can have a seat. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. It has been brought to my attention that Canadians are quite raucous. So I would like you to be noisy as we welcome beautiful young lady and my co-host for the rest of this event. Put your hands together, hit the table, drum rolls, make a noise. For Maya Thomas, please join me. Let's welcome, warm welcome for Maya.
thank you very much for that warm welcome.
We didn't hear that, did we?
Oh, yeah. I was just saying thank you for the warm welcome.
Okay. Now, Myert, this is a wonderful experience, is it, for you? Tell us about it. It's new for you.
Definitely very new for me. A little nerve-wracking, but I'll be okay.
Okay. All righty. We'll do everything that we can to shatter your nerves.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, these awards, as you know, we've been doing them for quite some time. So we're doing it a little bit differently today. I'm looking for page two of my stuff. Here it is, page two. And this is what it says. Silma wrote that, so, you know, if it doesn't say it right, it's her fault. It says, this year's submissions were judged by a panel of media and public relations experts who read, enjoyed, how do I know they enjoyed? Because they told us so, and determined the finalists and the winners. Before we announce the winners, before we present the finalists, let's first meet our judges. The former publisher of Canadian Yachting and now a freelance writer, avid sailor and golfer, she's president of TMAC, the Travel Media Association of Canada, Miss Elizabeth Kerr. She's in the room. She was one of the founding editors of Canadian Living and has been freelancing since 2000. Specializing in food and wine and spas and cruises and travel and all of the things that people enjoy when they go to the Caribbean, contributing to over 50 national and international publications. She's Anna Hobbs. Where is Anna? Did Anna stand? Is she in the room?
There she is.
Oh, there she is. Okay. Oh, lovely. Anna is currently the chair of the Canadian chapter of the Society of American Travel Writers. Our next judge, the managing partner and the senior vice president of Punch Canada, Jeff Lake. His career spans over 25 years between being in a newsroom and in the public relations field. Now, armed with 25 years' experience in the public relations industry, she was inspired to launch Spectacular Inc. with her partner, Peter, 19 years ago. Here's Jane Lloyd Jones, who is the next judge, and Jane isn't here today, she couldn't make it. Sir? Yes, she couldn't make it from the West Coast. Our next judge has two loves. Neither of which is a daughter or a son. One is the passion to communicate, and the other is a passion of ideas. From the Montreal office, the senior managing partner, Gavin Dumont. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for our judges, please.
And now,
I have to do that all afternoon long.
No, you're not. I can do it. Thank you very much. And now we'd like to present our chief judge. He's a Toronto-based writer, editor, media executive, who helped drive the digital transformation of many of Canada's major newsrooms. He teaches journalism in the School of Communications, Media and Design at Centennial College, where he coordinates undergraduate and postgraduate journalism programs, and a joint program with the University of Toronto Scarborough. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Tim Doyle.
Tim is going to say a few words.
Yep.
It's true, I actually am saying a few words, and a few that hopefully I can see as well. Anyway, thank you very much for inviting me to take part in this event today and for having a chance to be part of the judging panel. First off, I just, you know, if I could say just how much I enjoyed this assignment. I've been fortunate enough to have traveled around the Caribbean a bit as a tourist, and I realized in this crowd, having been to the Caribbean is not something that you take lightly. So I've been at least 5 times, okay, but I'm actually a more frequent reader of what's available at those destinations and many others throughout the region. You know, I even did a brief stint as a travel editor at a daily newspaper in Southern Ontario, and Caribbean coverage, especially this time of year, was essential. So to be asked to be a judge today and to review some of the work of so many top-notch travel journalists writing about Caribbean destinations, well, the answer for me was very easy, just to say yes, happy to do this. It turns out my task was even less onerous than that. I was told, just review the work of the judges. But I did review the entries as well. I read them and enjoyed them. And it was clear from the judges' comments and their evaluations, they took their task very seriously, which made my life easier, and you know, which really is what a Caribbean holiday is supposed to be about, isn't it, I think? Making our lives easier, helping us find a place to take a load off and enjoy life for a week or so. So my day job today is to run journalism programs at Centennial College and to teach journalism students about the business. And they've often been told over the years, don't tell me, show me. So when they're asked to write an assignment or take a picture, don't tell me about it, show me. But in today's world of instant communications, where everybody can be a writer, a photographer, a reporter, a videographer, the message is more likely, don't tell me, show me. And the best travel writing, or don't tell me, take me. The best travel writing has always had that ability to transport the reader to interesting and inspiring destinations near and far from home, like Martinique or Barbados, St. Kitts, St. Pierre, or even Nevis. So I'd just like to thank you very much for letting me be part of this today, and enjoy the rest of the lunch and the awards. Thank you.
And now we'd like to welcome back the Secretary General and CEO, Hugh Riley, to the stage.
I thought the recession was over. You know, I mean, the sparsity of applause, I mean, it's shocking. Absolutely shocking. And Mr. Riley will present the awards. So it's now time to present the media awards. This year we had close to 70 entries among a wide range of categories, in fact 8 categories. And let me take this moment to thank the journalists who submitted on their own. But also, yes, feel free to applaud yourselves. But also the national tourist offices of the CTO member countries that went out and got some of the submissions and made sure that we could see as many stories so Tim could have read as many as he did and enjoyed. So let's applaud our national tourist offices as well. They like that. You know. Now what we'll do, in the past, we presented awards to the honorable mentions and then the winners who already knew before they came here that they were winners. Today they don't. So for the first time, we'll release the names of the finalists, and everyone who wins here today will be as surprised as the other person because we hadn't told them. So we'll begin with the finalists for Been There, Wrote That, the best feature in a consumer magazine. The finalists are Living in the Past by Joe Matthews. It's a story about Nevis in Doctor's Review. Yeah, I forgot to tell you when we mentioned the finalists that you should applaud as loudly and as generously as you can. Finally awake. The Non-Connoisseur's Caribbean by David Majimsi, who wrote about Martinique in En Route. And
In Praise of Beans by Tim Johnson, who enjoyed Jamaican coffee, apparently. And now, the winner of this year's CTO Travel Media Awards Best Feature in a Consumer Magazine is... Thank you.
Drum roll.
You got it. You got it. She's smart. She's really smart. You're the only... No, I was about to say she's the only smart person in the room, but, you know. Living in the Past by Joe Matthias.
Thank you very much. It's always, always sweet to travel to your beautiful islands, and it's made even sweeter when you have an opportunity to travel there with your adult child, and that's what this story is about, and it's, I think, one of my favorite stories I've ever written. So I'd like to say thank you to the island of Nevis, and especially to Nisbet Beach Plantation, and to the CTO for this wonderful honor. Thank you very much.
Joe, don't go, please, because we'd like Brad from St. Kitts and Nevis is here, so we'd like him to join you for a photograph as well.
That we'd like to present is the I Couldn't Have Written It Better Myself Award for Best Feature in a Consumer Newspaper. The finalists are L'Abécédaire de la Jamaïque by Violaine Balivi for La Presse. Saint-Pierre Ressuscité by Hélène Clément for Le Devoir. Maybe There Is Something in the Water by Susan Campbell for the Globe and Mail. And the winner is, drum roll everyone, Saint-Pierre Ressuscité by Hélène Clément. Unfortunately, Hélène couldn't be with us today, so to accept this award is Roberta Garzaroli.
The next award, we call this one Inner Circle King or Queen. It all depends on whether it's male or female who wins it. It's for the best feature in a trade publication. Oh, this is quite interesting, really. The finalists are Ilona Koremsky, a new St. Kitts in Travel Industry Today. And
Ilona Karemsky, that's not a mistake. Havana still enthralls more than sunshine and beaches in travel industry today. Now, this is a surprise as to who the winner will be. And the winner is Ilona Karemsky of Travel Industry Today, a new Send Kit.
Take a ride with me through the Caribbean seas to a place where the faces are always friendly. Yeah, sun shines year around, beaches all around.
Kissed by the warm Caribbean sea and blessed with lush mountain vistas, St. Kitts is more inviting as a tourism destination now than ever before. Visitors are arriving from near and far to share in its rich heritage and to experience a colorful island culture. Come with us as we explore St. Kitts, an island on...
The Virtual Visitor Award for Best Online Feature is our next award. And the finalists are Susan Campbell, Getting Wet on Vacation, Dominica, for the Globe and Mail. Jim Byers, St. Lucia, Romance is a Caribbean Cocktail of Flowers, Sea Breeze, for the Toronto Star. Amy Rosen, A Resolution to Run is Easy to Keep, Jamaica, for the National Post. And the winner? Jim Byers, St. Lucia. Romance is a Caribbean Cocktail of Flowers, Sea Breeze.
I just thank you very much, guys. I adore St. Lucia. I just automatically assume I'm going to lose if Amy's in the contest, and I mean that sincerely because she's a real, just an outstanding writer and a really fun person. So I'm not terribly prepared, but I just want to say thanks. St. Lucia is one of those really, it's the word magical is overused, but I think it is kind of a mystical. Just incredibly beautiful, serene kind of an island with the pitons and the music scene, and it's an honor for me to win. And I just want to say thank you to people in St. Lucia because they're the ones that make it easy. All you have to do is go there and kind of let the rest happen. So thank you all very much. I appreciate it.
Next award, Not Lost in Translation. I have no idea what that means. I hope you understand the translation. It's the best feature by a Canadian journalist that appeared in a foreign media, non-Canadian media. And the finalists are Mark Stevens, Martinique, La Belle Island, For All at Sea. I realize Mark didn't applaud. Didn't approve, did you? Mark, you don't want to dance here, please. Melanie Reffers, Where to Sip and Snack in San Juan in USA Today. And because we like to do it twice, Melanie Reffers, Pretty in Puerto Rico in Jack's Facts.
Now, this year, we're presenting awards in two categories, in this category, so two subcategories. One is consumer, the other is trade. And so the winner of the award, best feature in a Canadian, by a Canadian journalist in a foreign media, consumer, is Mr. Mark Stevens, who will do the dance.
Make it so cold. Mountain
Thank you. Actually, I do want to, Martinique was a fabulous island, completely out of my comfort zone, one of the French islands. I know the Caribbean quite well. That was a new one for me. I do have to say, in my defense, it was actually all Johnson's fault that I ended up in Martinique, down for a SOTIC conference. So maybe I can come back to another one. Thank you, guys.
Mark, on the promise that you will never dance again, if you ever see Mark dance, no, I won't put you through this because you just had lunch. It's not pretty. It's not pretty at all. You want to give a demonstration, Mark? No, please, no. And the winner for the trade is Melanie Reffers, Pretty in Puerto Rico. Melanie couldn't make it today, but we have a representative from Puerto Rico who will come to accept.
For the Oh Snap Award for Best Photographer accompanying a feature. The finalists are Sharon Matthews Stevens, The Other Virgin Islands for Canadian Yachting. Susan Campbell, Great Adventure in Grand Cayman for Luxury Report. Melanie Reffes, Sipping and Snacking in San Juan for USA Today. And the award goes to Sharon Matthews Stevens, The Other Virgin Islands.
Thank you for the award. Many, many years of hard work studying photography. And thank you for the opportunity of traveling in the Caribbean so often. I want to thank Elaine and Brent Carnegie of CanLink, USVI Tourism, Elizabeth Kerr of Canadian Yachting, and also my husband, Mark Stevens, for publishing the story the other U.S. islands. Thank you.
And Mark, I will accept responsibility as well for getting you to SOTIC in the USVI. Yes, I'll do that. So we must actually always get you to SOTIC. As a matter of fact, no, because the other journalists do need to win as well, Mark. You keep it in the family. The husband and wife. And ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the award of awards. Everyone who's been a winner today has worked very hard to help promote the Caribbean, and we really can't thank you enough for that. But what we've done is we gave Jim the task of pulling all of these winners together and then determining from among all of these winners which was the best among the winners. And he said, it isn't an easy job because this is the best of this, this is the best in that. How do I get the best out of the best? But somehow, he was able to pull it off. And so they liked me. They really, really liked me. Now, it's nothing to do with me. It's got that's the title of the award, actually. It's the best among the best. It's for the most outstanding among all of the outstanding ones that we have, the cream among all of the cream and all of that. And this award goes to, wait a minute, let us start the clap, slow hand clap, slow hand clap. Okay, that's enough, thank you very much. The award goes to Joe Matthias. Living in the past, Nivis.
Thank you again to the CTO and to the island of Nevis for this wonderful honor. And any island that wants to contact me about traveling there, I'm happy to give you my business card. Thank you again for this wonderful honor.
So now we would like to congratulate the winners and invite the director of CTO USA Inc., Silma Brown, to deliver the vote of thanks. And we would like to thank the SG.
Good afternoon, everybody. Johnson always manages to assign me this task, the most humble, but I think the most important task of the day, and that is to say thank you to everybody in the room. Before I do that though, I want to first of all add my congratulations to all of the honorees for the fabulous job that you do in helping us to promote Caribbean tourism. First, I would like to thank the judges who had the challenging job of selecting the best from the lot of winners of submissions. And Tim, before I heard your speech this morning, I wrote in my script that you had the most difficult job. Contrary to anything that you say, that's my story and I'm sticking to it. You had to have had the most difficult job to select the best of the best from such a variety of excellent submissions. Thank you. To Mia and Johnson and Roberta, who was not on stage but had the task of managing the audio visuals, thank you very much for the fabulous job of hosting this lantern, and SG, for your role in presenting. Nobody presents better than you do. To the CTO member countries and their PR agencies for the excellent and large number of submissions this year. Thank you very much. We had a great representation of all of the categories in the selection of awards. To the NTO representatives, I want to acknowledge your contribution to the schedule of activities for Caribbean Week this year. Your involvement not only in the activities of the week, but in the planning process right from the beginning. This is an indication of what we can do when we work together, and I look forward to continuing to work with you. Ronald is back here. Ronald has been behind the scenes all week. Everything that happens here happens because of Ronald's contribution. We don't see a lot of him on the stage, but without him, very little of this would have happened. So thank you, Ronald. To the Rosewater Management, the staff, and the, well, they have an excellent staff, that's all I can say. I have a particular favorite, Hendrika. I call her the flower magician. She's not in the room right now, but if you could give her a round of applause, maybe her colleagues will tell her that we recognize her. To members of the Caribbean tourism industry, thank you for your support this week so far. Most importantly, I want to thank the media for thrilling your audiences with the most captivating images of the Caribbean. All the submissions are winners, but we had to select a few, unfortunately. And so the beauty that you articulated and the advantages of a Caribbean vacation results in millions of visitors to the Caribbean every year. Thank you for that, and continue to do the excellent job. To the airlines, Air Canada and the Caribbean Airlines, the writers tell the stories. You have your own initiatives that help to move people to the Caribbean. Thank you for the work that you do in helping us to move the bodies from Canada to the Caribbean. We look forward to continuing to work with you. Thank you for your many years of service. You are the champions of our industry, and we rely on you to execute the work that we do on behalf of the members of the organization. So I want to thank everybody for being here. Thank you for all of the influences you have on anybody who is interested in taking a vacation, and hopefully you manage to encourage them to choose the Caribbean among many other destinations. So I thank you for that. Thanks, everybody. I'll see you next year.
Yesterday at lunch, Silmer and I had a discussion with Sian, who is back there, about having someone who can speak French in a way that I couldn't do this. And Sian rang this young lady here and asked, will you do this? And she said yes, with very little hesitation. We had a discussion last night, and she was quite enthused about the whole thing. And I know Silma has already thanked her, but ladies and gentlemen, please really, really thank this Maya for me. She's done a wonderful job, and we're hoping, looking forward to working with her again. And I wanted you to leave in a hail of applause, you know?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I mentioned the State of the Industry Conference, which is what Mark referred to. In 2016, our State of the Industry Conference will be in Barbados. So we're looking forward to seeing every single one of you there. Please put 2016 on your calendar. October, we'll give you the precise date very, very soon. But October 2016, reserve for the State of the Industry Conference in Barbados, and none of you has an excuse not to be there, because you know early enough. There is nothing else that conflicts in your diary at this point, I can bet you. So please put it in there. Also, in terms of the awards, there are one or two categories that we didn't offer awards in. So there are other categories in which people can participate, so please spread the word. We didn't offer awards in the broadcast category, but we do have a broadcast category. And we've got a lot of journalists and media here who do broadcast pieces on tourism on the Caribbean. So next year, we're hoping to double the number of entries that we've had. So we do have a broadcast category. And we also, yes, so, and we also do have a category for non-Canadian journalists who appear in Canadian media. So if you've got writers from outside of Canada who writes for your publication, or who write for your broadcast media, whatever it is, please encourage them to enter. So there are various categories that were not represented here, and if you think that there are others that we should also include, please let us know. For example, there's a discussion on bloggers. Should we have something separate for bloggers? So please let us know, but next year we want to make it even broader than it was this year.